Students, whatever homework is given to you, you have to submit it on the very next day between 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. to the given WhatsApp number, and it is compulsory to submit your homework as your attendance will be marked on the basis of your submission.
Good morning, dear student. In this session, we are going to start our new sum number 11. Chapter number 5, Admission of Partner, Standard 12, Accountancy. Okay. Now in this sum, old partners, old ratio, and new partners, new ratio is given. And it is said that Prerna and Piyush are partners in firm sharing profit and loss in their ratio of their capital. Okay. Okay, now Prerna's capital. Prerna's capital is of rupees 50,000. Fine. And Piyush's capital is of rupees 1,50,000. On this capital, we have to find out capital ratio, and that ratio will become old partners, old profit sharing ratio. Okay, it means 1, 2, 3, 4, 0 cut. Fine. Now 5 is to 15. Okay, 5 1 is 5, 5 3 is 15. 1 is to 3 is our old ratio on the basis of capital. Okay, when in the sum new partner ratio and old partners old ratio are given, at that time this old ratio, profit sharing ratio, will become our sacrifice ratio. Okay, when in the sum old ratio and admitted partner share is given, so old ratio becomes the sacrifice ratio. It means this old ratio will become our sacrifice ratio. Fine. So old partner distribute new partner share of goodwill in 1:3. Okay. Fine. Now we are going to start our sum on the basis of adjustment and balance sheet. Okay. Now in the sum, a first adjustment is given as a they admitted Poani as a new partners for 1/5 share of profit as on 31/2016. Now first, in the first adjustment, Poani brought rupees 62,500 as capital and rupees 24,000 as her share of goodwill in cash, and 60% amount of goodwill is withdrawn by old partners. Now first, when brought, it means new partner has brought 62,500 as a capital. Okay, it means first cash and bank account debit side, we will write down to new partners capital account. Okay, capital is of rupees 62,500. Okay, same amount will be written on partners capital account credit side by cash account new partners capital 62,500 rupees. Okay, now new partner has brought 24,000 goodwill in cash. Okay, in working note, note number 2, new partners has brought capital and premium for goodwill okay capital is of rupees 62,500 and goodwill in 24,000 both the amount is brought in cash okay now this amount will be distributed between old partners Prerna and Pius as per their sacrifice ratio okay it means 24,000 okay it means for new old partners 6,000 rupees in Prerna account and 18,000 in Pius okay Here we will write down first two premium for goodwill account 24,000 partner capital account credit side by premium for goodwill account okay 6,000 and 18,000 okay now in first adjustment it is given that 60% amount of goodwill is withdrawn by old partners okay now 60% of 24,000 is 14,400 rupees okay this amount is withdrawn by the old partners right Now, total amount of goodwill is of rupees 24,000. 60% is withdrawn by the old partners. Okay, 24,000 multiplied by 60%, it means 14,400 rupees. Okay. Now this amount will be distributed between old partners as per their sacrifice ratio. Okay, 14,400 rupees. First, we are going to write down this in partners' capital account. Okay. Here we will write down to cash account In Prerna account, if you try count, 3600 rupees. And in Piyush account, we will write down 10,500 rupees. Same entry will be recorded cash and bank account credit side by Prerna's capital account, 3600 rupees, and by Piyush capital account, 10,800 rupees. Okay. Now we are going to solve our next adjustment. Market value of stock and machinery is rupees 20,000 and rupees 1,20,000. Okay. In balance sheet, asset side, stock is of rupees 17,500. Fine? Okay? Stock is of rupees 17,500. It means 2,500 increases. Revaluation account credit side by stock account 2,500 rupees. Okay? Fine. And value of machinery is 1,20,000. In balance sheet asset side, machinery is of rupees 1,70,500. Okay. Now by machinery account, value increases of rupees 12,500. Fine. Now first stock. Stock is of rupees 17,500 plus increase in stock 2,500. Total value is of rupees 20,000. Okay. After that, machinery okay 1,70,500. Fine. Plus increase in value of machinery 12,500. Means total value is of rupees 1,20,000. Okay. Now next is provision for bad debt is 10% and 2% is discount reserves on debtors. Okay. Our debtors is of rupees 30,000. Okay. Debtor says of rupees 30,000. Okay. Minus 10% bad debt reserve 3,000 rupees. Remaining 27,000 minus 2% discount reserve on debtors. Okay. On that 27,000, 2% 540 rupees. Okay. Our remaining amount is of rupees 26,460 rupees. Okay. Now, revaluation account debit side. On revaluation account debit side, first we will write down bad debt reserve. Okay. Bad debt reserve account. Okay. Amount of rupees 3,000. 3000. After that, next entry will be 2 discount, a reserve account, amount of rupees 540, right? Now, our next adjustment is creditors are to be paid 30,000. Okay, it means total creditor is of rupees 40,000, and out of that 40,000, we have to pay only 30,000. It means 10,000 is not paid to creditors. Revaluation account, credit side, by creditors account 10,000. Okay, second effect, balance sheet asset side, sorry, balance sheet liability side, creditors 40,000 minus not to be paid 10,000. Now next adjustment is value of building is to be increased by 15%. Okay, in the balance sheet building is of rupees 90,000. Okay, 90,000, 15%, it means 13,500 rupees. Okay, revaluation account credit side, by building account 13,500 rupees. Balance sheet asset side, okay, building is of rupees 90,000 plus increase in value of building 13,500, 1,30,500. Okay, now in that same adjustment, and value of furniture is to be increased by 20%. Okay, value of furniture is 70,500, 20%, it means 3500. Okay, revaluation account credit side, by furniture account 3500. Okay, value of furniture 3500 increases. Second effect, balance sheet asset side, furniture is of rupees 17,500 plus increase 3500, total value is of rupees 21,000. Okay, now next adjustment is outstanding wages of rupees 460 is not recorded in the books. It means outstanding liability. Okay, outstanding liability always recorded on revaluation account debit side. Okay, the revaluation account debit side, we will write down to outstanding wages account, an amount of rupees 460. Second effect, balance sheet liability side, outstanding wages of rupees 460. Okay, after completing the all adjustment, now we are going to solve the balance sheet. Okay, cash bank, cash and bank account debit side to balance BF 8,250 rupees. Then income of 750. Okay, balance sheet asset side, income of rupees 750. Okay, now balance sheet liability side, capital of Prerna is 50,000. Use 1,50,000. Okay, a reserve fund always distributed between the old partners as per their old ratio. Okay, reserve fund is of ₹30,000. Okay, partners capital account credit side by reserve fund account as per their old ratio 1:3. Total amount of reserve fund is 30,000. Okay, for Prerna 7,500, and in Pius total amount of ₹22,500. Okay, creditors and outstanding expense. Okay, now outstanding expense balance sheet liability side, outstanding expense is of ₹1,500. Okay, now completing all the adjustment and balance sheet, now we are going to find out the balance of the account. Okay, now revolution account credit side is of ₹42,000. After deducting debit side, there is a balance of 38,000. It means difference of amount of ₹38,000. This amount will be transferred to partner's capital account. We will write down to partner's capital account profit. Okay, this profit of ₹38,000 will be distributed between old partners as per their old ratio. Fine. This amount will be transferred to partner capital account credit side. Here we will write down by revaluation account profit ₹9,500, Prerna's account ₹28,500 in Pius account. Okay. After totaling partner's capital account, credit side is more than the debit side. Credit side total of Prerna is of ₹73,000. After deducting debit amount of ₹3,600, there is a difference of ₹69,400. Okay. Now Pius account total amount is of ₹2,19,000. After deducting debit amount of ₹10,800, there is a difference of ₹2,08,200. Okay. And new partner is ₹62,500. This amount will known as a to balance sheet. It means this amount will transfer to balance sheet liability side capital account. Okay, in capital, Prerna 69,400, Pius 2,08,200, new partner Square is 62,400. Total capital is of ₹3,40,100. Okay, now cash and bank account. Debit side total of cash and bank account is ₹94,750. After deducting credit amount ₹3,600 and ₹10,800, difference amount is of ₹80,350. Okay, this difference amount balance CD will transfer to balance sheet asset side. Cash and bank balance is of ₹80,350. Okay, totaling the balance sheet asset side total is of ₹3,70,600. Same liability side total is of ₹3,70,060. Okay, asset side is also ₹3,70,060. Okay, now we have completed our sum number 11. Okay, in next session we will continue our chapter. Goodbye, take care all of you.